Hi, Mike Corliss with Tormach. Today we're going to talk about establishing your work offset and then touching off a couple tools in the on the slant bed lathe. Okay. To establish the work offset, we're going to touch off with an empty holder. We'll touch off on the face of the part and the face of this tool holder, and that's what we're going to use to establish our work offset. That way, if whatever tool you're using, your insert breaks or whatever, you can always reestablish your work offset just using the holder. You don't have to worry about your repeatability with an insert or something like that. Okay, so clamp this up. Okay, now I'm just going to touch off on the piece of paper. Just bring it in until I get a light drag on the paper with the tool holder. Right there. Okay. Now, go to the offsets page. The offset table, and right now we have nothing in here. Okay, everything's blank. Okay, now I come down and I'm touching off my z-axis. Clean that off, and I want to include the thickness of my paper. Plus, we'll say there's 10,000 finishing stock on the front of that part. So I enter 0.013 for the 10,000 plus the paper. Hit enter. Okay, so now it tells me our Z position right now is 13 thou off the face. And if you look up here, it entered a work offset. Okay, that's the distance from the machine zero. When you reference the machine, if you zeroed it out there, that's the distance from the limit switch to how far you move to touch off the face of the part. Okay, now we can do the same on the X. To touch off an X, you want to know what the diameter is. You need to know the diameter that you're touching off of. So we'll call that 2 inches, 248 thousandths. And then I raise the tool holder up. So the face of the tool holder would be at the tangent location to the diameter. Right there. Then I do the same. I enter that diameter on the x-axis for the work. And seeing we're touching off from the front side of the part or the bottom side, the number's got to be negative. So I'll enter a negative 2. The stock's 2 inches, 248 thousandths. And then we got to add the thickness of our paper, which would be another 6 thousandths. So 2 inches, 254 thousandths. And enter. Now that entered an offset up here for the X. Okay, now we have our workpiece established, our G54 work offset established with our master tool holder. We'll call that our work offset holder. Whenever you're going to touch off a workpiece, you're going to put this holder in and touch off the face for your length and your diameter offset, okay? That's gonna establish your work offset. And from there, then we'll touch the tools off and then we'll get our tool offsets from there. So this is how you touch off tools, and they're gonna have a negative value when you're using the quick change holder and you're below center of the your workpiece for the diameters. If you're touching off and your tool holders are above, you're gonna have a positive diameter. That's what the difference is. When you're touching tools off. If you have a tool turret, it's the same thing. They're gonna be a positive value because you're gonna be up on the top side of the cutter, or the workpiece. Call this tool one, the turning face tool. Then we'll just touch off on the piece of paper again, just like we did with the tool for our work offset. We'll do the same thing for our tool offset. Okay. Sure, we got tool one in here. Tool one, enter. And then we pick the geometry of the cutter we hit. And our turning tool is this guy here. Click that. And now we've touched off on the faith, so we put in our 13 thousandths, 3 thou for our paper, and then 10 thou for our finish stock, 0.013. You hit touch Z. Now if we go to the offsets table, this value is the difference between our tool nose and the tool holder itself that we touched off on. On the offsets page, the value in the Z for the tool, that's going to be the difference between what we touched off on the workpiece and established our work offset from the face of this holder to our cutting edge on this tool, our cutting tool, okay? That's the dimension from here to here. Okay. Now when we go to touch the X off, that value is going to be the difference from where we touched off here and the cutting notice radius up here. Okay. Okay, we got the cutter dragging on the piece of paper. We'll enter our value in the box here. Remember, it's a negative value because you're on the bottom side of the diameter, so negative 2.254. Touch X. Okay. Now, the value that shows up on the offset table is the difference from the face of what we touched off our workpiece and our cutter, but it's shown as a diameter. So this distance is going to be radially, so you'd have to multiply this distance by 2, and then that's what's going to give you your number on your offsets page. Okay, so our number on the offset table is 2 inches, 223 thousandths. If we measured the distance from here to here, it would be half of that because it'd be radially. Okay. Now we'll touch off a grooving tool. Okay, now we go to touch that tool off, go to tool touch page, tool 2, pick the cutter geometry, and come in on the side of it again. Okay, now when we go to touch Z for the grooving tool, the offset is actually on the center line, so we got to add half of our grooving tool thickness. And that grooving tool measured 197 thousandths. So if we add half of our grooving tool, would be, we'll call it 98 thousandths, plus our 10 thousandths finished stock. So we're at 108 thousandths plus our paper. We'll enter 111 thousandths for our touch Z offset. Okay. And then our diameter is the same as what it was on the other tool as far as the touching it off part. Our diameter, -2. If we check the offset table, those are our values. What else? That should be about it, I guess, for this.